Hello everyone, happy learning and thanks for participating in this activity. Today, in this video we will cover this new swarm intelligence based algorithm named as brainstorm optimization algorithm. This algorithm is introduced in year 2011 and this algorithm is also tested on different benchmark test functions to check algorithm effectiveness and its performance. And here you can see algorithm main inspiration. This algorithm is basically inspired by the human brainstorming. Now first question is, what is human brainstorming? Brainstorming technique is now widely used in different fields to solve problems because this technique encourages collaboration, teamwork, innovations. So it is widely used now. Brainstorming sessions are now widely used in different areas to solve real life problems. So what is brainstorming? It is a group activity that is designed to generate a large number of ideas for any problem. So in simple words, we can say a group of people, they share thoughts, combine ideas and improve their ideas over time to find the best solution for the current problem. Now suppose in any company, a group of people combine together, they are trying to solve any problem. Now here they will exchange their thoughts, share ideas, then combine their ideas, improve them over time to find the best solution. And here you can see brainstorming is now used in different fields, for example in business and marketing. In business and marketing, for example, to develop new applications or the next model of any smartphone. So like that you can see we have different fields where brainstorming is used now in education, healthcare and all. So what is brainstorming, how it works? This we will try to understand using different real life examples for better understanding, and we will use different examples to understand how this brainstorming process is simulated in this optimizer to solve complex optimization problems. So first, what is brainstorming? How it works? This we will try to understand using a real life example. After this, step by step we will cover how brainstorming process is simulated in this optimizer. Now let's start it. Here you can see key principles of brainstorming. Focus on quantity over quality and create wild ideas. There is no judgment or criticism. Then we will combine ideas and improve them over time. So here you can see brainstorming process steps. First, define the problem clearly. Set a time limit for discussion. Next, generate ideas freely without any judgment or criticism. Encourage participants to share more ideas. In the end, record all ideas, evaluate and refine ideas. Now let's try to understand brainstorming process working using a real life example. Imagine we have a new ice cream company that want to launch a new and unique flavor to attract more customers. So here, instead of depending on one person's decision, company organizes a brainstorming session with their team. So step one, we have defined the problem. Now suppose product manager, that is the team leader. So here, team leader start the brainstorming session by clearly stating the goal that we want to create an exciting new ice cream flavor that customers will love. And the team sets a time limit of 40 minutes for idea generation. Second step, generate ideas. Now everyone can share ideas freely without any judgment or criticism. Now everyone is sharing ideas freely without any criticism. So here you can see first member we have John. What about something exotic like mango chili? Next, Julie. How about bubblegum cotton candy? Next we have Tom. Trending flavor we have here, strawberry cheesecake. Sophia, that is our customer feedback specialist. Many customers ask for coffee caramel popcorn. Suppose a discussion going on for 40 minutes and here no idea is rejected. Third step, increase creativity, that is building on each other ideas. And team leader reminds everyone to think widely, so no idea is rejected at this stage. Step 4, evaluate and shortlist ideas. Now team will vote based on uniqueness, taste and customer interest. Suppose after voting, they narrow it down to mango chili and strawberry cheesecake. Step 5, now we will select the best idea. Now they will test it with customers. Now Sophia conduct the taste test with customers, and customer love the mango chili the most. After this, Julie creates a marketing campaign, Spicy Mango Delight, the summer sensation, and John finalizes a recipe, and the company launches the new flavor. So brainstorming helps team come up with innovative ideas through oneness. So brainstorming optimization, it is a new swarm intelligence algorithm that simulates the human brainstorming process. Here you can see, in this algorithm, individuals are grouped and diverse in the search space. Here you can see we have two major operations in this algorithm, convergent operation and divergent operation. Brainstorm optimizer process, two kind of functionalities. We have capability learning and capacity learning. Capability learning, that is the convergent operation, and capacity developing, this is the divergent operation. So how this algorithm works? This algorithm works like a brainstorming session in a team where people come up with and improve ideas. So we have capability learning and capacity developing. Capability learning, that is the exploration phase. We have here divergent thinking. Capacity developing, this is the exploitation phase, means convergent thinking. In capacity learning, it's like generating new and creative ideas in brainstorming session. So algorithm explore different possibilities by creating new solutions from the existing one. And capacity developing is like filtering and improving the best solution. This allows the algorithm to focus on promising areas where best solutions are likely to be found. These two processes repeat in cycles, exploring new ideas and then refining them. So here you can see solutions keep improving over time. This algorithm is simple and easy to use. Here you can see three key steps followed in this algorithm. We have solution clustering, new individual generation and selection. In solution clustering, algorithm groups similar solutions into different clusters. This is like sorting ideas into categories. Second, we have new individual generation, where new solutions are created based on one or more existing solution from the clusters. If new solution is close to the best one found so far, then the algorithm focus on refining good ideas, that is exploitation. Second case, if the new solution is created randomly or by combining ideas from different cluster, it help explore different possibilities. So this is exploration. Third, we have selection. If new solution is better, it replaces the old solution. Else, we will keep it as the best solution. Now here you can see how this algorithm is working over time in different iterations. In the beginning, algorithm explore the entire search space looking for the good solution. Here you can see over time, solutions are grouped into clusters, helping the algorithm narrow down the best areas. Then here you can see the balance between exploration and exploitation phases is stabilized, that is leading to an optimal solution. Exploration means we are finding the new ideas, and exploitation means here we are refining the good ideas. So this is similar how brainstorming lead to the best ideas through discussion and refinement. Now let's try to understand this using simple example. Suppose we are trying to find the highest hill in a large landscape. So this is the search space and we are trying to find the highest hill. So each individual in our algorithm representing a person standing at certain height, that is the solution. So here each person is our solution. So our goal is to find the highest point, that is the optimal solution. So step one, we will initialize. So we will randomly place 6 individuals in different location on the landscape, and here each individual height is measured, then it is evaluated. Here you can see we have person A, B, C, D, E and F. Then we can see the location X, Y for person A 2, 3, person B 7, 2 and so on. Then we will evaluate the height. Suppose we have evaluated height means fitness for the person A 50, B 40, C 60, D 30, E 55, F 35. Second step, clustering. Clustering means grouping similar solutions. Now we will group similar solutions. So here we will group the individuals into two clusters based on their proximity. So we have cluster 1 and cluster 2. In cluster 1, we will keep higher ground. In cluster 2, we have lower ground. So higher ground we have for A, C and E. Lower ground for B, D, F. Third step, new individual generation. Now we will randomly select one or two clusters to generate new individuals. So case 1, we have here exploitation. We are defining the best solution. Case 2, exploration means we are trying to find the new areas. Case 1, if we select any cluster, we will generate a new person near the best one in the group. You can see person C at 60 height. And if we will new generate, then it is with height 62. That is slightly better than 60. Second case, if we pick one person from each cluster. For example, suppose we pick person C from cluster 1 and person B from cluster 2. Now we will create new person at midpoint. So here new person we have 4, 5. You can see with height 45. Here you can see this is the mixture of good and bad solution. Fourth case, we have selection. Now we will keep the best solution. So we generated new individuals. Now we will perform selection. So we will keep the best solution. So here each new person competes with the existing person at the same index. If new person is better, then we will replace it with old one. So here we will keep the better solution only. After this, we will repeat until stopping condition is met. So here you can see this algorithm is working by grouping, generating and selecting solutions in a way that mimics the human brainstorming. So solution clustering means we are grouping the similar solutions. So this algorithm groups similar solution together. This is like sorting ideas in categories, and different methods like k-mean clustering or other techniques can be used for this grouping. And over time, solution will gather in the best area, helping the search becoming more focused. And here a random replacement chance is added to avoid getting stuck in one area, that is the local optima. For example, if we are searching for the highest hill in the landscape, we first group people who are standing in the similar height together. Second, new individual generation. New individual generation. So here we are creating new ideas. New solutions are generated based on one or more existing solution. If new solution is based on one cluster, it fine tunes the best existing idea. So here we have exploitation. If new solution is based on two clusters, it explore new areas by combining different ideas, that is exploration. So we have new individual generation in algorithm. This is similar like creating new ideas in brainstorming session. So new solutions are generated based on one or more existing solutions. If new solution is based on one cluster, it fine tunes the best existing idea, that is exploitation phase. If new solution is based on two clusters, it explore new areas by combining different ideas, that is exploration. Third, we have selection, means keeping the best solution. So after generating new solution, we keep the best ones and discard weaker ones. But this process ensures that over time, the overall quality of solution is improves. So this is a population-based meta-heuristic optimization algorithm, and the main inspiration we have the human brainstorming process. This algorithm is basically designed to solve complex optimization problem. Now question is how this algorithm solve complex optimization problem by simulating the brainstorming process. This algorithm basically mimics the way human generate, combine and refine ideas during brainstorming sessions to find optimal solution. Here you can see different set of parameters. We have population size, number of clusters, then we have predefined probability values, then maximum number of iteration and other parameters. So first we will initialize all the important parameters. First step, we will randomly generate n potential solution, that is our individuals. So each individual is representing the potential solution to the optimization problem, and each individual is typically represented as a vector in the search space. Second step, we have clustering. So we will cluster n individuals into m clusters. So we have population size n. Now we will cluster these individuals into m clusters. So set the value for cluster. So here we can use clustering algorithm like k-mean. to group similar individuals into clusters, and each cluster represents a group of related ideas or solutions. Step 3, we have evaluation. Now we will evaluate the fitness of n individuals using fitness function. So we will calculate the fitness score for each individual, and based on their fitness value, we will determine the solution quality. Step 4, ranking and cluster centers. Now we will rank individuals in each cluster and record the best individual as the cluster center. Here, best individual in each cluster is the one with the highest fitness value for the maximization problem, and we will consider the minimum fitness value for the minimization problems. Step 5, random value generation. Now we will randomly generate a value between 0 and 1, and we will use this value to decide whether to modify the cluster center or generate new individual. First case, we are modifying the cluster center. So here we are generating the random value. So if this value is smaller than predefined probability value, then we will randomly select a cluster center, replace the selected cluster center with the randomly generated individual. You can see here, this step is used to introduce the diversity and prevent the algorithm from getting stuck in the local optima. Next step, we have generate new individual using one of the following method. Here, we can generate new individuals either by random value generation, or we can generate new individuals from a single cluster. So first case, we will randomly generate a value between 0 and 1. Second case, if the value is less than probability value, then we will randomly select a cluster with probability value, generate a random value between 0 and 1, and if the value is smaller than the predefined probability, then we will select the cluster center and add random value to generate a new individual. Otherwise, randomly select an individual from cluster and add the random value to it to generate new individual. And other option we have, we can generate new individuals from two clusters. So we will randomly select two clusters and generate a random value between 0 and 1. If the generated value is less than the predefined probability value, then we can combine the two cluster centers and add random values to generate a new individual. Otherwise, we will randomly select two individuals, one from each cluster, combine them and add a random value to generate new individual. Step 7, we have selection. So we will compare here newly generated individuals with the existing individuals at the same index. So based on fitness, we will rank the individual and record it as a new individual. If n new individuals have been generated, then we will move to the next step, else we will go back to the step 6. In step 8, we will terminate. We will check the stopping condition. If stopping condition is met, then we will stop, else we will go to step 2. We will again form clustering and evaluation. So that's all about this video. If you have any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.